Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing programming in Java. So under this we will discuss command line arguments, type casting and variables. Command line arguments, we need to take input from the keyboard while running the program. Type casting means the process of converting one data type into another data type. Variables are the memory locations stores the values of the data. Okay. Now we are discussing about command line arguments, variables and type casting. So command line arguments are parameters that are supplied to the application program at the time of invoking it for execution. So args 0, args 1 are the command line arguments. Now these are of type string, so that we are converting that string into an integer with the help of wrapper classes integer dot. The method available in it is parseInt. Integer dot parseInt of args 0 means string is converted into integer and assigned to s1. Similarly, args 1 value is assigned to s2. So in the simple example we are taking, so the args are available here, same name we used in the program as arguments. And the second important point is args 0, first argument is assigned to s1, second argument is assigned to s2, third argument is assigned to s3. Now we are finding the total, and so sorry, this is 3. After that we are finding the average total by 3. So what is the value we are getting? That value will be total and average also we printed. So here the output will come like this. Okay, shall I go next? Next one is variables. A variable is a basic unit of storage which represents memory location in which value can be stored. Rules for creating variables is similar to rules for creating an identifier. Already we discussed the section, so now I am not discussing rules for creating a variable. So declaration of variables. Before using any variable, it must first be declared. A variable declaration specifies the data type, the variable name, and optionally the default value for the variable. Syntax for creating a variable is data type variable name, also called as identifier, is equal to default value. This is an optional part. Okay, that's why we represented in curly brackets. So byte b, int age and enroll number, boolean male. So these are the different types of variables we defined for different data types. So now giving values to the variable. So in the syntax it indicates that name is this. So int year is equal to 20. Once you have declared the type of a variable, you can initialize it with some value. Scope of the variables. Java actually has three kinds of variables: instance variables, class variables and local variables. Instance variables are created when the objects are initiated, and therefore they are associated with the objects. They take different values for each object. Class variables are similar to instance variables, except their values apply to all the instances of a class rather than having different values for each object. Local variables are declared and used inside methods. So variables are also the key to creating programs that can perform calculations. Types of variables are class variables, instance variables, local variables, final variables and shadowing variables. So now we are discussing about class variable. A class variable is a variable that any method in a class can access, including static methods such as main. When declaring a class variable, you have two basic rules to follow. The one is you must place the declarations within the body of the class but not within any of the class method. Second point, you must include the word static in the declaration. The word static comes before the variable type. So here I am representing hello message is a class variable of type string, and here I am using static means it is a class variable. Okay, I call this hello message and assign the value inside the main method, and I also print them. I remove the quotations. We need to print the hello message, automatically it prints a hello world information. In the second one, instance of, An instance of variable is similar to a class variable but does not specify the word static in its declaration. So if we ignore the static keyword, automatically it is an instance variable. Instance variables are associated with instances of classes. When I am not indicating static keyword, it indicates an error that cannot make a static reference to the non-static field hello message. It indicates the type of error. Now, local variable. A local variable is a variable that's declared within the body of a for method. You do not specify static on a declaration for a local variable. Local variables are not given initial default values. The compiler checks to make sure that you have assigned a value before you use a local variable. So here I am using not outside the main method. I declared the hello message within the main method, and I also use this printed in this. The scope of the hello message is in the main method, not more than that. So the next one, final variables. A final variable, also called as a constant, it is a variable whose value you cannot change once it's been initialized. So here static we declared, but we cannot use the keyword final. So here static final string hello message hello public static, the remaining is common. Okay, initially here I am putting hello, here I am trying to change hello world, it indicates an error. After putting comments here, automatically the value hello world value will be printed. So here also we remove quotations, all the places we remove quotations while printing the system.out. So the last one is shadowing variable. This is little bit special for us. A shadowing variable is a variable that would otherwise be accessible but is temporarily made unavailable because a variable with the same name has been declared in a more immediate scope. The scope of a variable refers to which parts of a class the variable exists in. So here in the class I declared two variables, that is name and age, and I assign the values. Again I am taking display method, again same variable names, but I am assigning new values to them, and when I am printing it, automatically the values are printed. Okay, so what value it printed? It is Vishnu and 22 will be printed, not Krishna and 25. We need to print that values. We need to do some changes. I will tell you when I am doing practical. So the last concept in this is typecasting. The process of converting one data type into another data type is called typecasting. In Java there are two types of casting. Widening casting or automatic casting are also called as implicit type casting. Converting a smaller type to a larger type. So the range is byte to short, short to character, character to int, int to long, long to float, float to double. If we apply for byte to short, no need to apply the type casting mechanism. If you want to convert from byte to character, also not required. Int also not required, long also not required, float also not required, double also not required. Short to character, short to int, short to long, short to float, short to double, character to int, like this we cannot, no need to convert. But narrowing casting are also called as explicit type casting, or also called as manual type casting. Converting a large type to a smaller type, reverse it. When converting from double to float, we need to apply the mechanism. So how we need to do means, so data type 1 variable 1 is equal to value, in the second line data type 2 variable 2 is equal to data type 2 variable 1. Using these two lines, we are converting manually from one data type into another data type. So, first one, Widening casting or automatically type casting or implicit type casting. Widening implicit type casting takes place when two data types are of automatically converted. This happens when the two data types are compatible. When we assign value of a smaller data type to a bigger data type. Here int is we declared and we convert this int into my int into double by my double or not required any type casting, automatically it is converted. That is called widening casting or implicit casting. So when narrowing casting or manual casting or explicit conversion, if we want to assign a value of larger data type to a smaller data type, we perform explicit type casting or narrow casting. This is useful for incompatible data types where automatic conversion cannot be done. Here, target type specifies the desired type to convert the specified value to. So here, I am doing double some value. Now that is converted into integer. So already I specified the syntax. This is the first data type 1 and variable 1 value, data type 2, variable 2, data type 2 and variable 1. Automatically the double 9 will be assigned to my int and we need to print it. So this is the way we are converting from one data type into another data type. Thank you.